Hello and welcome to another uMake tutorial. This is the fifth section in the How to Create a Modern Home tutorial series in uMake. My name is Nico, and in this tutorial, I'm going to try and add some colors and a few more details to this design. As you can see, the design of the house is starting to come along and look really nice. So let's go ahead and start adding some color to this to make it look even nicer. The first thing I want to do is I'm going to go through and just select all the surfaces that are going to be glass and give them kind of a light transparent blue color. So we know this is going to be glass, this is going to be glass. All of these that I left in are going to be glass. Now, as you can see, I'm only working on one side right now. You can use the same concepts of the separating surfaces on the other sides. I'm just doing this for time reasons. So I'm going to change the color, give it kind of a nice light blue color. That looks nice. Change the opacity, bring the opacity down to, let's say, 85%, something like that. And that looks pretty nice. All right, perfect. Now I want to do a contrasted color just to make this all look a little nicer and kind of make some other things pop. So I'm going to select this cube and make this kind of a dark navy blue. I think that'll look really nice. There we go. I'm going to reserve the inside surface. I'm going to do something even more interesting with that. And this surface I'll make a nice dark blue. So I'm going to come over here to the colors. I think I have one that I used in the color history. I think this is it. There we go. And you can see that kind of pops out, and I think that looks pretty cool. Now we have these two balconies that we made. I'm going to make those glass as well. Select those railings there and this one here. And we're just going to go back into the color history and use this nice blue that we made. That looks good. Now for the inside of this, I'm going to actually use a texture. So I'm going to come over and go to the textures, the photo panel, and then over into textures, go to wood, and I think I'm going to use new planks here. I'm just going to drag this in and drop it there, and now I can change how many times this repeats, so I'm going to boost that up. 4 looks about right. Yeah, it looks really nice, and I'm going to actually put that all around the inside of this. So just do that again. And I'm going to make that 4. And I'm going to rotate this actually 90 degrees. And do that on those internal surfaces. Hit the green check mark, and we'll do it on the inner surface of the top as well. Just rotate that, make it go to 4. There we go. So that looks pretty nice like that. All right, so now we've added those colors. I think that looks pretty nice. And the next, let's see. Next thing I want to do is I kind of want to build a ground plane. So I don't need this box over here. This has kind of been floating there just in case I needed it before. I'm going to get rid of this, erase it. I want to move the car under this kind of overhang, and the reason that I initially did that was to act like a car park. This would shade the car. You could park it under and it acts like a self-supported car park. So I'm just going to move these two elements over like that. And now I want to build kind of a ground plane that we put the house on. So I'm going to go to the top view and just draw a big, huge rectangle. Hopefully this will take. There we go. And you will use the last color that you used. I'm going to select this. Go to my color history. I think I have a nice green that I used in the past. This one might work. Okay, yeah. Okay, that looks nice. And there's kind of the ground plane that we have. And I'm going to kind of divide this. What I want to do is I want to come in here. I'm going to draw a rectangle. There we go. Move this curve back. Oh, actually just going to rescale this a little bit and then move it. Along that surface. And I'm actually going to use a push and pull functionality here, and this is going to be a pool. I'm going to pull that down. That only went down 5 feet. Let's go down 8 feet. Like an 8 foot pool. There we go. And we can actually have a little bit of fun here. We can come down from the side view, select this curve, and just move this up to give kind of an angled bottom. There we go. This is going to create this surface here. I want to copy this and move it down just a little bit like that. And the reason I copied it is because this, the one on top that was generated when we changed that angle, I want to actually erase this one. So let's see here. Did that work? There we go. And this I'm going to change to a nice deep blue color. So there is our pool in front of the house. And that is the modern home that we created. So just like that, with a couple building blocks, and kind of moving some things around using the push and pull functionality, adding some textures and some colors, within a pretty short amount of time, you can get to a pretty convincing and interesting design. I really encourage you to explore shapes and just kind of build some blocks and then change the shape of those blocks and move them around and see what you get to. That's pretty much what I did in order to develop this tutorial series. I just kind of had some fun. I have almost no background in architecture, but I went online, looked at some inspiration, and came up with this design. If you have any comments, questions, or feedback for us, as I've mentioned, definitely put them down below in the comment section. We love hearing from you. You can also find us on Facebook, YouTube, Instagram, or Twitter. And send in your comments and feedback. And also your suggestions if you have any ideas of other tutorials you would like us to do. With that said, I hope you enjoyed this tutorial series. This concludes the one for the modern home, and we can't wait to see what homes you create. Take care, guys. Have a wonderful day. Bye-bye.